Hi everybody, Mary Grothy here, CEO of Sales BQ. Welcome to the Quota Crusher podcast. Today we're talking about one of the greatest topics ever, objections. I'm going to tell you why objections should be your best friend. Sales reps have been trained for years to wait for the objection, and then they get it and they go, and they get all hopped up, and then they launch at the prospect because they are so ready to handle that objection. Unfortunately, when you do that to your prospect, they don't like it very much, and then they don't really feel like objecting to anything else that you have to say. So you might find them taking a back seat. They then aren't as engaged in the conversation. They're not telling you everything that would be helpful to you progressing the deal because they didn't like how you handled the first objection that they gave you. How can we think about objections differently? Well, I believe that objections should be your new best friend. When a prospect objects in a sales conversation, that's actually a good thing because they're talking to you. Anytime an objection comes up, it's because they didn't understand something that you said, or maybe they had a past prior bad experience with a vendor just like you, which is causing some hesitation or concern. Maybe your pricing and the way that you put it together on your proposal is actually confusing to them and they're not understanding it and they're not certain what it is. A lot of different reasons cause objections, but they should be welcomed in the sales conversation. You'll hear me say this over and over throughout our training and these podcasts, but I've sat in thousands of sales meetings, my own, and then of course through the work that we do shadowing in the field with reps. And I feel like the buyers, I can see some apprehension. Sometimes they are hesitant to even share the objection, and it's all about how the salesperson handles the first objection that comes up that's going to set the tone for the rest of the meeting. Sometimes an objection triggers a salesperson. They get panicked, or sometimes the salesperson doesn't hear it correctly, and it's not a good situation. So here is an approach that will help you handle objections appropriately and use them to your advantage. First, just stay calm when they share the objection with you. Don't react. I want you to absorb what they just said and really make sure you understand how they objected or what they're saying in the objection. A great strategy is to either restate the objection or ask for further clarifying information. If you can separate your reaction and come up with a very purposeful, strong response, you'll be in a better position and you're gonna sound more like a consultant. So, buyer objects. What do? Stay calm and you think about what they said. Then you're gonna empathize with the situation, align with them, go into the moment with them that's causing the objection, see it from their perspective. Then either ask a clarifying question, or if you fully understand the objection is, this is too much money. Okay, that's pretty straightforward, but you can still dig into that further. Well, tell me more about that. Well, what about the proposal is causing concern? Well, what on there is standing out to you that it's maybe outside what you were expecting? But get further clarification. Price objections are, that's a whole podcast on its own. Remember that? Price objections, separate podcast. Okay. But when you get an objection on price, we can dig into it a little bit here. One, you should have on the front end confirmed the budget step before you ever put a proposal together. There should be no confusion by the time you're presenting price, but oftentimes our proposals that we put together as salespeople might be confusing. You sell what you sell every single day. The buyer buys what you sell, not that often. Maybe once a year, once every 3 to 5 years, maybe even once in a lifetime. They may have never seen your type of proposal before. Maybe it's confusing to them and they're not sure. But that right delivery and having a conversation and digging into it and asking clarifying questions is a great way to work with that objection. Let's rewind a little bit and go to the other place that objections happen, which is when you're prospecting. The best way to avoid an objection with prospecting is to not sound like every other sales rep on the planet that triggers the buyer. few things that you can do. One, do some research before you prospect. Two, have a talking point. I don't need you to do a day worth of researching on this prospect. Just find a talking point, something that you can bring of value. Construct a powerful value prop that doesn't have anything to do about your company and your products, your services, and your title. It's all about the pains and problems that you solve of that buyer. And I want you to do a multi-touch cadence before you pick up the phone. So you're prospecting, you can connect on LinkedIn, you can send an email, you can do a direct mail piece, you could do a drop-in, you can leverage LinkedIn's mutual connections, find someone you're mutually connected to, get a secondary warm introduction to that person before you ever pick up the phone. By the time you pick up the phone to call, but please know, I am telling you to pick up the phone. Cold calling is not dead. By the time you pick up the phone, you have other touch points that you can reference in that conversation. And when you call them, you have something specific, something relevant, something about them, you've done your research, and you've got a really strong value prop about a very specific pain and problem that you solve based on their role, their industry, their title, and whatever trigger event, market event, whatnot that you found when you were researching them. That is going to reduce the buyer's objection to you significantly. When you're strong in the opening, then there's a smaller chance that they're gonna say, I'm not interested, or this isn't the right time, or no thank you, or whatnot, because you said something actually very powerful. So there's a tidbit there to reduce the amount of objections. But I'll give you a little something here. If they say to you, hey, I'm not interested, there's a great pivot. Is it the timing of the year or what we do? And allowing them to explore conversation after that point. All right, going back into the sales conversation. When objections happen, embrace them and make them very conversational and be thankful. Change your mindset about the objection. Be thankful they're talking to you because you're only there for a certain amount of time during that sales meeting. And if they're not communicating with you, once you leave the building, they're going to meet internally and they're going to talk about your products and services and you when you're not there. That's when a lot of the objections come up. So wouldn't you rather they be brought up in the sales meeting? Well, I would. Here's the last thing that I'll leave you with today. You've been doing what you do for a while. You've sold your product or service, or you've been in your industry for a while, and you know what the most common objections are. What if you go all the way through a meeting and it seems a little too agreeable and a little too easy? What if there's an objection that they didn't bring up that you usually hear in your sales meetings? I think some of the most powerful salespeople, the ones who aren't afraid to talk through the tough challenges, actually bring those up proactively. So we're a small company at SalesBQ, and we've got some big name competitors. And when I'm talking to a prospect that has used big name sales training firms, I know that our lack of name recognition might hinder us in the process, might hinder our opportunity to win, especially the larger the client that we're selling to. And when I don't hear an objection about our size or lack of name recognition, I like to bring it up. And I ask if it causes hesitation or concern on their end and who internally would give them pushback because of our lack of name recognition and our size. That is so powerful and it creates unbelievable dialogue. But you have to have a lot of confidence to ask a question that big, bold, and powerful, especially if you feel like the sales meeting's going extremely well. You don't want to rock the boat, but you have to use your spidey sense and your gut feeling to know this might seem a little too easy. And if you're not getting signed paperwork right then there on the spot, and there's another step in the process, I'd highly recommend proactively bringing up some of the biggest objections that you normally get when you're in the sales conversation. But there's your quota crushing sales tip for this week, and we're glad you could join us.